हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट रिवीजन ऑफ योर यूनिट टेस्ट। सो देयर आर थ्री चैप्टर्स विच आर गोइंग टू बी कमिंग इन योर यूनिट टेस्ट, दैट इज चैप्टर 1, 2 एंड 3। सो इन दिस टुडे क्लास 6, सो सब्जेक्ट मैथ्स एंड रिवीजन ऑफ यूनिट टेस्ट 1। सो हेयर वी आर गोइंग टू, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट योर सिलेबस एंड देन द पैटर्न ऑफ योर यूनिट टेस्ट। सो हेयर लुक अबाउट the syllabus. So as you know, the syllabus of your unit test, there are three chapters, that is chapter number 1 number system, chapter number 2 factors and multiple, and chapter number 3 that is whole number. So these three chapters are going to be come in your unit test. Now after this, see the pattern of the paper, that means what kind of paper you have to solve. So in this, see, this paper will divided into 5 parts. So here, first of all, A part will be multiple choice question. So see, there will be total 50 marks paper will be there. So total marks will be 50, and time will be provided 2 hours. And here see, A part, that is multiple choice question. So in multiple choice question, there are 5 question and each question carry 2 marks. So total 10 marks are there for multiple choice question. Now in B part, true false, total 5 questions are there in true false and each question carry 1 mark. Similarly, in match the following, also each question carry 1 marks and total 5 questions are there. So 5 marks for all. And in D part, fill in the blanks. So each question carry 2 marks, so total 10 marks. So here one word answer. In E part, you have to give one word. So in this question, all the question will carry, total number of question will be 5 and each question carry 4 marks. So in this one word answer, you have to solve this question and you have to write correct answer. So in this way, total number of question will be 25 and total marks will be 50 and total time will be provided 2 hours. So in this way, you have to solve your unit test paper. Now after this, we are going to discuss some important questions. So first of all, see chapter 1, that is number system. So in number system, first question is define the counting number and whole number. So what is counting number and what is whole number? So first of all, you have to write the answer of counting number. So counting numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So numbers starting from 1 and they never end, so are called as counting number. Similarly, what is whole number? So a whole number, when 0 is added to the list, that means when in counting number we include 0, so that means from 0 to all the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, from starting from 0, that means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and all these number are called whole number. Now after this, see question number 2. In question number 2, we have write the following number in words. So we have to write these number in word. So here see this 85706. So this means you can write it as 85706. Similarly, see next 90560, this is 90560. And after this, see 533888. So this will be 533888. Similarly, see 500119. So it will be 519. So in this way, you can write these number in word. Now after this, see question number 3. In question number 3, we have write the following number name in the numeral. You have to write these number name as numeral. So A part 65708. So you can write it as 65705. Similarly, 878040, you can write it as 878049. Then 962370. So this you can write as 72. Okay, so it will be 962372. So you can write it here 72 also. So its full is 172. Here you can write 2 also. Okay, in this way you can solve this question. Now after this, see next. So in question number 4, write expanded form. So here you have to write the expanded form. So here see question number 4, first part, 70,540. So you can write this as expanded form, that is 7, first of all 70,000 plus 500 plus 40 plus 0. Similarly, here 580,698, this also you can write it as, here first of all 5 lakh, then 80,000 plus 600 plus 90 plus 8. So in this way, here also 12,508, here also you can write it as like this. Okay, so in this way you can write it. Similarly, D part also 5600003, so you can expand it as and write it in this way. So in this way you can write the expanded form. Now in question number 5, write in short form. So these questions are given, so you can add these and you can write it in short form by adding. So you have also done these type of question previously. So these kind of question you can do the addition and you can do write the short form as directly. Now after this, see question number 6. Find the difference between the place value and face value of 7. So here place value of 7 will be 700. So in question number 6, the place value of 7 is 700 and face value of 7 is 7. So difference will be 700 minus 7 will be 693. So in this way you can do this question. Now after this, see this. So here chapter 2, factors and multiple. So in this chapter, see question number 1, learn and write the various type of number like even, odd, prime, composite, natural and whole number. So you have to learn the definition of even number. So first of all, see even number, as you know, all the multiples of 2 are called even number. So all the multiple of 2, of you can say the number which are divisible by 2 are called even number. Now after this, see odd number, the number which are not multiple of 2 are called odd number. Now prime number, the number which have exactly 2 factors, namely 1 and itself, is called a prime number. So in prime number, the number which is divisible by 1 or itself. For example, there are so many numbers like this. For example, 2, 3, 5, 7, and so many numbers are there which are divisible by 1 or itself. Now after this, the composite number, the number having more than 2 factors are known as composite number. Now natural number, all the counting numbers are called natural number. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. Now whole number, when 0 is included in the natural number. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these all numbers are whole number. Now after this, see here question number 2. So in question number 2, we have find out the composite number and prime number between 1 to 100. So here we have to find out prime number and composite number between 1 to 100. So first of all, see composite number between 1 to 100, these are the composite numbers between 1 to 100, and these are prime numbers between 1 to 100. So in this way we can find composite number and prime number between numbers 1 to 100. Now after this, see question number 3, write down all the factors of 3, 2, 8, 0 and 75 separately. So here we have to find all the factors. So here 32, 80 and 75. So factor of 32 are, these are the factors of 32, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, and factor of 80 are 1, 2, 4, 5, 8, 10, 16, 20, 40 and 80. Similarly, factors of 75 will be 1, 3, 5, 15, 25 and 75. So all these are the factors of 75. So in this way you can do these kind of questions. Now after this, see divisibility test. So divisibility test is also important. These all the tests you have to learn and you have to write so that you can learn them. So see, first of all, divisibility test of 2. So a number is divisible by 2 if its one digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. That means when the last digit of any number, that is one's digit, will be 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then it will be divisible by 2. Similarly, see divisibility rule of 3, the number is divisible by 3 if the sum of its digit is 3. When the sum of number is divisible by 3, then we can say the number is also divisible by 3. Now divisibility rule of 4, the number is divisible by 4 if the number formed by its digit in the tens and ones place is divisible by 4. That means when the number formed by its tens and ones digit, or you will add these, suppose we are having any number, for example we are having 1 1 2, so here the tens and unit digit is 12. So this 12 or 1 2, this 12 is divisible by 4. That means we can say this full number, that means 1 1 2, will also divisible by 4. That means here we will see last two number. When the last two number will divisible by 4, then whole number or full number will be divisible by 4. Now here see divisibility of 5. So the number is divisible by 5 if its one digit is 0 or 5. That means the last digit of number is 0 or 5, then it will divisible by 5. Now see divisibility of 6. The number is divisible by 6 if it's divisible by each 2 or 3. That means when any number is divisible by 2 and 3 both, then that number will also divisible by 6. That means we have to, when any number is divisible by 6, that means we have to check them for divisibility test of 2 and 3 also. Now divisibility test of 7, the number is divisible by 7 if the difference between twice the ones digit and number formed by other digit is either 0 or a multiple of 7. That means when we write any number, then the difference between twice of ones digit. So here for example, suppose when I take any number, suppose 14. So here it is saying that twice of ones digit. So twice of ones digit, here ones digit is 4. So 4 into 2 will be 8. So when the difference of 8 and 1, that is equal to 7. So this 7 is divisible by 7. That means this full number, this 14, is also divisible by 7. So here first of all you have to multiply the last digit by 2 and then you have to subtract that number from the remaining part, and if the number is divisible by 7, then we can say that full number is divisible by 7. Now after this, see divisibility by 8. So here a number is divisible by 8 if the number formed by its digit in 100 tens and ones place is divisible by 8. That means you have to see the last three digit. If these three last three digit are divisible by 8, then the full number will be divisible by 8. Now divisibility by 9. The number is divisible by 9 if the sum of its digit is divisible by 9. When the sum of all the digits are divisible by 9, then we can say the number is also divisible by 9. Now after this, see divisibility test by 10. A number is divisible by 10 if its ones digit is 0. So say here 10, when the last digit is 0, then we can say the number will divisible by 10. Now divisibility by 11. So it is important, divisibility by 11. A number is divisible by 11 if the difference of their sum of its digit in odd places and sum of its digit in even places is either 0 or a multiple of 11. That means वैन वी राइट, फॉर एग्जाम्पल सपोज आई एम राइटिंग हेयर 121, सो इन 121 हेयर दीज आर ऑड प्लेसेज, वन एंड दिस वन इज ऑड प्लेसेज एंड दिस इज इवन प्लेसेज, सो हेयर टू इज इवन एंड हेयर वन एंड वन दिस इज ऑड प्लेसेज. सो हेयर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सम ऑफ ऑड प्लेसेज, सम ऑफ ऑड प्लेसेज 1 + 1 विल बी 2 एंड सम ऑफ इवन प्लेसेज दैट इज 2. सो वैन वी सब्ट्रैक्ट दिस 2 फ्रॉम 2 दिस विल बी 0. दैट मीन्स वैन द दिस डिफरेंस ऑफ places on odd and difference of places on even will be 0. That means we can say that the number is divisible by 11. So here you can do some more example related to this divisibility test of 11. Now after this see next. So here whole number, chapter 3 whole number. So first of all write the smallest even number, smallest even prime number. So the smallest even prime number is 2. So here see question number 2, learn and write distributive property of addition and subtraction. So what is distributive property of multiplication, addition here? So here distributive property will be a into b plus c. So here distributive property of addition and multiplication, you can see it is same. Just when we say about multiplication, so in multiplication we have, in multiplication we use multiply sign and in addition we use addition sign. So here we are showing this distributive property for both multiplication, also multiplication over addition also, and multiplication over subtraction also. So we have to show over addition and subtraction. So here a into b plus c will be equal to a into b plus a into c. Now distributive property of multiplication over subtraction, it will be a into b minus c equal to a into b minus a into c. So after this see question number 3. In question number 3 we have write the predecessor of the smallest 3 digit number. So predecessor means we have to subtract 1 from the number. So first of all here 3 digit number, smallest 3 digit number will be 100. So here we will subtract 1 from 100. So 100 minus 1 will be 99. Now after this see question number 4. In question number 4 the additive inverse, see, write the additive inverse of 38. So in additive inverse we change the sign. So the additive inverse of 38 will be minus 38. Now question number 5, find the difference between 8540 and 999 by using a property. So here we have to use one property. Here 8540 minus 999. So here 8540, on place of this 99 we can write 1000 minus 1. Now after this we can use a distributive property. So when this 8540, this minus will multiply inside, so it will be minus 1000 and minus minus will be plus 1. By solving it, so it will be 8540 minus 1000 and plus 1. So by it solving this, answer will be 7541. So in this way we can solve. Or here we can do one more thing also. This 8540 will add with this one, so it will become 8541, and 8541 minus 1000, the answer will be 7541. Now after this see question number 6, find the value of 645 into 13 plus 645 into 7. So in this question we can take here 645 as common, so in bracket 13 plus 7 will be there, and 13 plus 7 is 20. So here 645 into 20 will be 12900. So after this it is all about your chapters. So you have to revise all these three chapters including true false, fill in the blanks and MCQ question. So after this, thank you for watching this video, एंड विश यू ऑल द बेस्ट फॉर योर यूनिट टेस्ट. सो थैंक यू.